Get ready to match the stars. Nipsey Russell, Brent Summer, Charles Nelson Riley, from WKRP Cincinnati, Lonnie Anderson, Jack Jones, and George Beulabot as we play the star-studded big money match game PM. And now, here's the star of match game PM, Gene Rayburn.
Come to my dressing room right now. Here we go. That's the way you feel about it. I greet you. Oh, aren't you beautiful?
We'll bring you right
back. Oh, you're a lovely bunch.
Thank you.
Will you join me in welcoming our two players here, Julie Pockernegg and Chuck Kindig? Now, let's get acquainted, shall we? Find out a little bit about each of you. Chuck, where are you from and all that?
I'm from Big Bear, where I make my living as a carpenter.
Yeah.
And I'm originally from Leavenworth, Kansas. I better throw that in or the folks back home will never forgive
me.
I'm married to a beautiful woman by the name of Ann. I have a daughter by the name of Dana and a son by the name of Matthew.
You left out one thing.
What's that?
You like blue.
I love blue.
Yes. Blue tie, blue shirt, blue suit, blue trousers.
Blue eyes. Blue eyes. Blue eyes. Look at his eyes.
Blue underwear.
Blue underwear.
Blue shoes. No. Calfskin shoes. Okay, Chuck, welcome. Julie, what about you?
Well, I'm originally from Spokane, Washington.
Right.
And I moved to L.A. about a year ago. I'm an aspiring singer that's not aspiring so fast, so I work as a temporary secretary.
Uh-huh.
And I'm getting married in June.
Good.
That's what my father said.
Nice long eyelashes. All right, good luck to both of you here on Match Game PM. Each of you will have three opportunities to match as many of them as you possibly can. And the one who's done that most often at the end of the third round will be the winner. That person will go on to play the big money super match, which can pay off over $20,000. There we go. Chuck, A or B?
Try A.
Chuck says he wants A.
Why
here it
not
is.
Give it
a A said. A. Fred said, when my lawyer said that he'd take my case to a higher court, he really meant higher. When I walked into the courtroom, the judge was on blank. Fred said, when my lawyer said that he'd take my case to a higher court, he really meant higher. When I walked into the courtroom, the judge was on blank.
Uppers.
Uppers! These carpenters will fool you every time. When you expect a carpenter to say stilts, huh? This one says uppers. Hey. Okay, Chuck. Yeah, Chuck says uppers. Sophisticated.
I got along well with you, Gene, and I expect a carpenter to say what you expect a carpenter to say. Stilts.
Okay, we have a sophisticated carpenter in our midst.
Has he got any uppers?
No.
I'm sorry, stilts.
All right. Yes, sir.
Judicial stilts.
Judicial stilts. They're a little different. Okay, Lonnie Anderson. Yes. Fred said, my lawyer said he'd take case to higher court. He really meant higher. Walked into the courtroom. The judge was on.
He was on stilts.
All right, we got four of those so far. Chuck. Okay, Jack.
Well, I'm going to Big Bear, I'll tell you that.
Big Bear.
He said he was on grass.
Uh-huh.
All right.
Watch it now. Okay, Miss Rosebud.
I love Big Bear. That's a nice place. You said he was really high, right?
Really high.
I said he was on cloud nine.
Cloud nine. Heavy high.
May I be excused?
Yeah, no, hang around now. Okay, Chuck, that's your first round question. And now we've got one for Julie. Harry said, I really feel out of place. I feel like blank at an Osmond family reunion. I feel out of place. I feel like blank at an Osmond family reunion. Anytime, Nips.
Okay.
Sure I will, Julie. Here it is. Harry said, I really feel out of place. I'm just reading it for her.
okay? Harry said, I really feel out of place. I feel like blank at an Osmond family reunion. You know who the Osmonds
are?
Yes, I
do.
Well, they had this family reunion, uh-huh. You see.
I don't know. Just a priest.
A priest.
What do you expect from a Catholic?
Well, it's true, they are Mormons.
Yes.
And a priest. No, but, you know. Look into
Mormons
their eyes. You think anybody's here is going to say priest, Julie?
Would you?
All right. Nipsey, what have you got?
The...
Really out of place would be the Jackson 5.
The Jackson 5? Okay. What'd you say?
Well, they represent the good old things in this country, purity and all that stuff.
Yes.
So I figured somebody like Xavier Hollinger would really be out.
Excellent. Yes. That's the drift.
See, I think these two are spies.
Who?
The contestants.
Oh, Julia.
They say code
spies?
Words like uppers and priests. Tanks could be rolling.
Uh-huh.
This is it.
Yes.
This is your definitive.
Okay.
Stinks.
A dentist.
A dentist. Julie's looking for a priest, Lonnie.
Well, I don't think she'll find it here. I said Richard Pryor.
Richard Pryor. Excellent. All right.
Well, along the same lines, Red Fox.
Another good one. Red Fox.
Okay.
And another good one.
I said Gucci Gucci Charo.
Charo. Another good one.
Well, I had
some wonderful answers there, but not from you.
That's right.
Now we've got a little business to do with you. Okay, we got a zip-to-zip tie here. We'll go to round two here, and since Chuck went first last time, Julie, we ask you to go first this time.
A.
Okay, A. Barry said,
A.
The food at that restaurant was so rotten when the waiter... Oh, I'm sorry. That's my fault.
Give him another chance.
Barry said, the food at that restaurant was so rotten.
How rotten was it?
Perfect.
Hey.
When the waiter brought the steak, he asked me if I'd like to eat it or blank it. Okay, Julie, Barry said the food at that restaurant was so rotten. When the waiter brought the steak, he asked me if I'd like to eat it or blank it.
Wear it.
Good. That's okay. Wear it is okay.
Yeah, I ate at the restaurant was so bad, I told the waiter, I said, take this slop back to the chef. He said, if you're taking it to him, he won't eat it either.
Eat it or wear it.
Eat it or wear it. Yes.
Thank you. I've been to that restaurant many times, unfortunately. He said, eat it or kill it.
A rare steak.
Eat it or beat it.
Eat it or beat it. Has a certain lilt to it there, Charles.
Yes, there
Lonnie,
is a lilt to it, isn't
food
there?
Food in the restaurant is so rotten, the waiter brought the steak, asked me if I want to eat it or blank it.
Revive it.
Eat it or revive it. A little high, was it?
Food is great. Food is great in this place. 50,000 flies can't be wrong. I said smoke it.
Eat it or smoke it.
I love that thing.
I've been on that stuff all night.
I have not.
You
leave
him alone.
Okay, Joyce.
Leave him alone. He's adorable.
Well, I thought maybe the steak was so tough he put it on the bottom of his soles and wear it.
Wear it. Keep it moving. All right, Chuck, here you go. Otto the Optimist said, there is something good in everything that happens to me. Like last week, I was run over, but I had the good fortune to be run over by a blank. Had the good fortune to be run over by a blank. Okay, Chuck, guess we're about ready for you. Here we go. Otto the Optimist said, there is something good in everything that happens to me. Like last week, I was run over, but I had the good fortune to be run over by a blank.
Ambulance.
Yeah!
Oh, that's good. I like that. He came up with a good one.
That is a good one.
Yeah, no man is so bad, but what that a woman can make him worse.
An ambulance. Okay, Chuck, you got one.
No answer's so good that I can't ruin it. I said Volkswagen.
Why?
Well, it's a little car, and if you got run over by
it, it would hurt just as bad as a big car.
No, just it wouldn't.
Yes,
well,
it would.
You prefer a great big A&P truck?
No.
A Briggs truck.
A doctor, maybe?
An A&P truck. Try to keep the references in the last 50 years.
Try to buy clothes that aren't 50 years old.
Hint, hint, an ambulance.
An ambulance. Score got tied 2-2. Had the good fortune to be run over by a...
An ambulance was the perfect answer, but I thought maybe cheerfully a good humor truck.
A good humor truck. I want chocolate. Okay, Jack.
How bad can it be to get run over by a blimp?
A blimp.
Wouldn't hurt.
Would cast a shadow, that's all. What have you got there, Joyce?
I thought he got run over in good taste by a Mercedes.
A Mercedes?
Don't mention
all right.
That
Nazi. Here we go. Round three. Score is tied, 2-2. Score. Julie went first last time, so Chuck, you go first this time.
B.
Okay. Ethel said... That stupid surgeon made my new nose out of the skin from my foot. And that's why my nose has blank. Okay. Ethel said that stupid surgeon made my new nose out of the skin from my foot. And that's why my nose has...
Athlete's foot.
Okay. You got friends out there? Relatives and friends?
My wife.
Oh, your wife. She's very vocal. How about it, Brett?
You have awfully pretty blue eyes, and I'm really sorry. I said corns.
Corns. That was a good choice. Corns would have been one of the good ones.
Yeah.
There it is. That's why my nose has...
Of course. Athlete's foot.
Okay, Chuck, you got three. What do you got for the young fellow there?
Corns.
Corns. Corns and athlete's foot were the two good answers there. And Joyce has?
Athlete's foot.
All right, you got four now. Now, Julie, we're getting to the end here.
Oh, that's right.
You need 2 to tie and 3 to win.
Okay.
From his hospital bed, Tom said, today I got 2 cards. My mother sent me a get well card. My mother-in-law sent me a get blank card. You hear all that?
How's it gonna come out?
Ready? Here we go. From his hospital bed, Tom said, today I got 2 cards. My mother sent me a get well card. My mother-in-law sent me a get blank card.
Worse.
Get worse card. She said, my mother-in-law sent me a get worse card.
I think she blew it.
Oh, I'm sorry. I said get lost.
Charles?
I'm sorry, get lost.
Oh. Now, let's see. You must match the 2 remaining players, Lonnie and Jack, to stay in the game and achieve a tie. Lonnie, what have you got?
Oh, I'm sorry. I said a get sicker.
Get sicker. It's all up to you, Jack.
Lost.
Get lost. So that means Chuck Kindig wins the game. Julie, some gifts will be coming your way.
Great.
Thank you very much for being with us.
Thanks.
Goodbye,
so
Julie Pockenberg.
Bye.
Here's a little message for you. Hurry back. Chuck here, in his blue outfit, is standing on a little blue dot in the rug, and everything's okay. Chuck, time now for the Big Buddy Super Match. You can win over $20,000 here. To do that for you, we're going to have 2 audience matches. Let's begin with the first one. We polled a studio audience not too long ago. Said, write down your best answer to this. Code of blank. $500 for you for matching their most popular answer. $250 for the second most popular. and $100 for matching the third. Whom do you call on for a little assistance here? You're allowed three.
Chuck Nelson Riley.
Oh, me! No, when I was in the Bronx and we had no money, I was born, we had a coat of arms. Two roaches on a field of linoleum. Coat of arms.
Okay.
Coat of arms? Coat of arms.
All right, that's his answer.
Well, don't all turn on me because I could go to a sitcom.
That's right.
Who else? Anyway.
Let's try Nipsey.
Code of Ethics.
Code of Ethics.
And Jack.
Now they've used them all up. Honor. Good. I thought it. Boy, am I smart.
Audience, you must learn to enunciate more clearly.
Honor.
More coaching, please.
Yes. Code of Honor, Code of Ethics, and Code of Arms are the three you have.
I like Code of Ethics until Jack said Code of Honor.
Yeah, you
and
like that
kind
better.
Of...
Code of Honor.
But I think I'll go with Code of Ethics.
Okay. Okay, that was Nipsey's answer. Let's see if we have Code of Ethics under the $100 number. As a decoration in the meantime. So, Charles answers up there, Coat of Arms. That
Say
audience.
Say it again. Whose answer's up
it's
there?
Chuck Whoa. Nelson Riley's.
Right on.
All together.
Charles Nelson Riley.
Thank you. Okay, let's see what we got on the $250 number.
Coat of Honor. Honor.
Well. I guess your judgment is going to be right here. It looks to me as if ethics will be on tops. Let's slide the big one. Yeah! Yes, of course. We have a carpenter here who does all the repair work, Charles. Now you won $500, means at least you'll play for us 10 times that amount, or $5,000. We're going to see now how much more you'll win with your second audience match. Blank snapper. Okay.
Well, Nipsey got it for me last time, so let's start with him this time.
Oh, man, I don't know. Finger snapper?
Finger snapper.
Okay.
Oh, no, we
are. You don't like that?
Oh, no.
How about a little snapper?
What about this pretty girl here?
I'm getting to her in a minute. I'm saving the best for last.
Oh, wait, no, then I won't be able to think of anything.
Brett.
I resent that. What about red snapper?
One more.
And now Lonnie.
Well, red was all I could think of. Quickly.
What red snapper?
Whipper. Oh, that's wonderful. Whipper snapper.
Whipper snapper. So you got whippersnapper, red snapper, and finger snapper. Do you want one of those, or have you got a better one in your head?
Again, I had my mind made up for red snapper until someone came along, and I think I'll stick with red snapper.
Red snapper, all right. Let's see if we have a red snapper under the $100 number. Garter snapper. Can't hardly find them anymore. We're a dying breed. May we see the next one, please? Whippersnapper, okay, that's the audience's answer. And the last one, if you would.
Yeah,
you got it. Okay. Another $500, multiplied by 10, another $5,000. Got about a $10,000 to shoot for. However, if you have a lucky spin of the star wheel, you'll be playing for $20,000. Good luck, give it a spin. Here we go. All right. Any of the gold star areas? Okay, get over there. Now, audience, this is one place where you cannot help. Please do not say an answer here. because it may be a rotten answer, and then if he uses it, he blows the money. Okay, thank you for your cooperation. Good luck to you. Here it is. Mill blank. That's M-I-L-L blank. Mill blank. No community decisions here. Just put it in the slot, and away we go here. All right, she's finished her answer, and you give us the answer that she has on the card, and you get $20,000.
Mill stream.
Yeah! Mill stream. You thought a long time, didn't you? What other thoughts were going through your head?
Mill house.
You're thinking mill house.
Mill house.
Yeah, but you said mill stream.
I was thinking the old mill stream.
The old mill. And that's mill pond.
Mill pond is another good one. Mill sap.
I hate being in this position.
Why?
Because. And I really feel awful. That's a terrible thing to do to me. Because I have to give you $20,000.
This is his code of arms. Two red snappers on a mill stream.
Okay. Now we got a little message for you. Hurry back. $21,000. Join us next week for another exciting, fun-filled match game. PM Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye. Thank you.
This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game PM. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.
Are you watching, you little rascals?
Oh, it's fun, isn't it?
And who subscribes to it?
Go on, push the button.
Think of the fun you could have on
the tube.
The tube?
You.
Tube.
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 TV tubes.
That's a lot of fun, isn't it?
It's gonna be a lot more fun
if you keep going the way you're going.
Go on, push the button.
Please subscribe.
I hope they're watching.